In Hillsborough County, they're starting to flatten the curve, but leaders voted today to get rid of its curfew just 3 days after they put it in. Not because of improvement, but because they said it was redundant to the safer at home order. County Chair Les Miller was the one who brought the idea of a curfew forward, but that didn't sit well with many people. Nightside's Angelina Salcido shows you why the curfew was dropped.
An emotional meeting between the Hillsborough County Emergency Policy Group led to the scrapping of an overnight curfew. Chairman Les Miller was at the center of it all.
The mere fact is that I'm trying to save lives in this county.
But that didn't stop Chairman Les Miller from receiving almost 600 hateful emails after passing a 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. curfew in Hillsborough County.
The most difficult one was being called the N-word and a Nazi.
They're just unwarranted. This is the chair of the county commission who has done so much throughout his career to help our community.
Sheriff Chad Cronister defended Miller, saying the decision was made with good intentions.
I was one of the individuals that voted for the curfew on Monday. I think me, along with everyone who voted in favor of it, their heart was in the right place. But I think we did it a little too hastily, and then it wasn't communicated properly, so it confused the public even more.
That's why Cronister voted to rescind the mandate today. He says the safer at home order that's in place has enough restrictions.
I feel that we've imposed enough personal restrictions. People understand the CDC guidelines and they're following or they will be following.
The sheriff's office reports over 300 violations of the safer at home order in the county since March 27th, and there has only been one arrest. Pastor Ronald Howard Brown was charged after bringing hundreds of people together for a church service.
Since then, everyone's been extremely compliant.
Sheriff Chad Cronister says that they're doing their best to not arrest anyone during this time. They're counting on people to act responsibly and help flatten the curve.
One other note from that county meeting, leaders voted against requiring everyone in the county wear masks or face coverings whenever they leave in their home. Instead, they asked for people, just please follow the CDC guidelines and wear them so they don't have to force you to do so.